channel Technical Knowledge with Engineers. Today in this video, we are going to learn about green chemistry. So let's get into the video. So green chemistry, by its name, it is related to the environment. In this, we have to do reaction which will not harm the nature and beneficial to the nature. It is also called as a sustainable chemistry. It is defined as the use of a chemistry for pollution prevention by means of a chemical products and processes that reduce or eliminate the use of and generation of a hazardous substance. It means the green chemistry program supports the invention of more environmental friendly chemical processes which reduce or even eliminates the generation of a hazardous substance. Or the other definition we can say is design of a harmless process to produce various hazard-free product has emerged as a new branch commonly known as a green chemistry. There are 12 principles of a green chemistry which was developed by Anesthes and Werner. The 12 principles are: first is a prevention of a waste, second designing safer chemicals, third maximize atom economy, fourth less hazardous chemical synthesis, fifth safer solvents and auxiliaries, sixth design for energy efficiency, seventh use of renewable feedstocks, eighth reduce derivatives, ninth use of a catalyst, tenth design for degradation, 11th real-time analysis for pollution prevention, and 12th inherently safer chemistry for accident prevention. So the very first principle is prevention of a waste. It is a method which eliminates or minimizes hazardous waste that will pollution prevention, that cause pollution prevention. In this design, chemical synthesis in such a way that we prevent waste. We know every day, every hour, see hundreds of tons of hazardous waste are released into air, water and land by industry. They release byproducts such as HCl, O2 and many other, which cause waste. So it is better to prevent waste than to treat or clean up waste after it has been created. It is ability of a chemist to redesign chemical transformation to minimize generation of a hazardous waste is a important step. So from this, the conclusion comes out that chemical process should be designed in such a way that less or no byproducts are formed. Second is design of a safer chemicals and products. Chemical products should be designed to carry out their desired function while minimizing their toxicity. Design safer chemicals means products should be designed to be used for their purpose while minimizing their toxicity. When creating a product, design it to have the greatest efficiency possible if the lowest amount of toxicity to the user, earth, etc. For example, medicines that we buy from the shops, when this medical drug to be introduced in market, first put on the trial to check toxic effect on humans. If it is toxic, alternatives are prepared such that only toxicity is reduced and not the efficiency. So we have to do chemical producting design that will give high efficiency but the low toxicity. Just creating a new product with lower toxicity to replace an existing product helps the cause. Next is maximize atom economy. In this, design synthesis so that the final product contains the maximum proportion of the starting materials. Atom economy is a concept that evaluates efficiency of a chemical transformation and calculate as the ratio of total mass of atom is designed product to the total mass of atom in reactant. As you can see in this formula, percentage of atom economy equals to number of atoms in product to the number of atom in reactant into 100. A high atom economy means that less waste is created and the reaction has a high efficiency. Next principle is use of a safer solvent and auxiliaries. Use of auxiliary substance like solvents, as you can see in this picture, solvents, separating agents should be avoided whenever possible because solvents such as acetone, benzene, ether are highly inflammable that will cause explosion, and other chemicals such as CCl4, CHCl3, aniline are harmful for the health, and some are carcinogenic also. That means can cause cancer. Thus, it should be avoided. If solvent is very necessary, water is a good medium. It is eco-friendly solvents which do not form smog or destroy ozone layer. For example, dry cleaning fabrics. Dry cleaning fabrics. First, we were using toxic solvents. Perchloroethylene was used earlier. But now green chemistry has created liquid CO2 by replacing this. Next is less hazardous chemical synthesis. Design synthesis to use and generate substance with little or no toxicity to the either humans or the environments. Essentially, it means making smarter choice in your selection of chemicals. Choosing chemicals that will not have harmful reactions or create harm in any way, shape or form. Even choosing to replace harmful chemicals used in very low amount for another safer alternative. This also means that whenever possible, your methods should also reflect this safer approach. Ensure that there is little or no toxicity to human health and the environment with what you are planning to generate or the product you are creating. For example, the release of chlorofluorocarbons and related compounds generating during chemical process contributes to the hole in the ozone layer. This increases amount of harmful radiation making its way to the earth surface. By reducing and using less harmful chemical, you can protect the earth. We all know that all components have safer alternatives, but taking the time and efforts to the search for those alternatives is a part of working as a green chemist. Next principle is design for energy efficiency. Aim is to increase efficiency. Energy required in chemical process should be minimized. For this, we have to carry out reaction at amendment, which means room temperature and pressure, whenever possible by using catalyst and stopping excessive use of a fossil fuel. We have to stop the use of a fossil fuel and instead of that use catalyst. Recently found substituents, that is microwave radiation and ultrasounds used in process requiring very less energy. Better energy efficiency can be achieved by proper heat transfer and minimum wastage of energy during process. Next is avoid or reduce chemical derivatives. During synthesis, derivatizations such as blocking or protecting groups should be avoided if possible. Derivatives use additional reagents and generate more waste. Two synthesis steps are added each time. When one is used, overall yield and atom economy decreases. As when we use multiple groups, like when we are for we are generating a reactant A and making a product D, but between this we are using derivatives B, C. So we have to avoid this because it increases step of process. Hence, additional reagents are reduced, also generates more waste. To avoid those effects, alternatives reagent should be used. Means, instead more selective and better alternative synthesis sequence that eliminates the need for functional group protection should be adopted. And one of the best alternative is catalyst. Next is the use of a catalyst. As in the derivatives I said, the best alternative is a catalyst. Because in this selective catalyst reagents, catalyst used in a small amount and can carry single reaction many times. In stoichiometric reagents, it used in excess and work only once. In this, selective catalyst reagents are preferred over stoichiometrical reagents. We should minimize waste by using catalytical reaction. Catalytical reaction are faster and thus require less energy. That is our aim. As you all can see in this reaction, when we use stoichiometric reagent, we get byproducts. There is which byproduct we have formed is totally waste. And in catalytical reaction, there is no waste generated and the reaction is also fast, and hence we use catalyst. So by using catalytical reaction, it faster the reaction and requires less energy. So we have to we should use catalyst. Next is design for degradation. It means chemical products should be designed so that at the end of their function, they break down into innocuous degradation product or non-hazardous substance and do not persist in the environment. Design for degradation is the teeth green principle of a green chemistry and currently one of the largest challenges in the green chemistry. It is hard to design stable products that function competitively for their purpose while understanding the degradation mechanism to determine if they are toxic. This is why I believe the teeth principle is one of the most important green chemistry principle, as it is one of the hardest one to achieve. Why it is hard? Because the product we have formed in past, they are now non-degradable. As an example, we can see pesticide that was used, DDT, is residue remains in the soil, and it for many years it is remain in the soil and cause pollution. By not using DDT, we can use the alternative as biodegradable insecticide. Second example is plastic. As we all know how dangerous it is now becoming to our environment. So using a plastic or a polystyrene, it also not non-biodegradable and cause solid waste. By their alternatives are biodegradable plastic containing cellulose and packing pellets made up of starch. Or we can also use jute bags and etc. Next is a real-time analysis for pollution prevention. Analytical method have been developed to allow online monitoring and control prior to formation of hazardous substance. As chemists, we conduct several experiments every day. Depending on the type of chemistry, the whole of this experiment can be synthesize a novel target compound, design newer chemical processes, or simply study the properties and reactivity of the compound of interest. In a lot of these cases, it is necessary to use various analytical techniques to monitor the reaction. In the case of the simplest chemical reaction, reactant A and B react together to form a product C. How do we know when the reaction is complete? Typically, we can use some technique. But in many industry settings, it is crucial to have suitable analytical methods to monitor reaction in a real time. The scale of the reactions performed at these plants are big enough such that issues that we typically consider being only minor ones at the research lab scale can become very problematic afterwards. For example, preparation of ethylene glycol, if the reaction conditions are not monitored perfectly, toxic substances are produced at high temperature. So that's why we have to do analysis. Next is inherently safer chemistry for accident prevention. Design chemicals and their physical forms, solids, liquids or gases, to minimize the potential for chemical accident, including explosion, fires and relatives to the environment that are releases to the environment. Use of a safer chemicals, minimizing temperature, pressure and using catalyst helps in minimizing potential of accidents which is derivable. These all are the principles of a green chemistry. So lastly, I say thank you for watching the video and don't forget to like, subscribe and comment below if they're about this and share the video. Thank you for watching.